Hopefully I've made a few videos that I've been a part of a few videos that, to quote Wood on this one, made 5 minutes out of your day a little bit better over the last couple years. Hopefully you made some videos that made you guys laugh or you guys thought was awesome, and thanks.
You meet a lot of people over the course of your life. You see a lot of faces, you hear a lot of names. Most you forget. There are only a few that will ever really leave a lasting impression. Wouldn't it be something if one of those people was a complete stranger you met on the internet? Yeah, it's a long story.
What's up, guys? My name is Hutch. I make Call of Duty videos and I put them on the internet.
Four years ago, Shaun Hutchinson, or just Hutch for short, created his YouTube channel. He started this channel to have some fun as he noticed a few other users began uploading footage of their video gameplay. Hutch would begin doing the same, focusing on the first-person shooter, Call of Duty. Hutch wasn't the first to start posting video game footage to YouTube, but he was the first to really stand out from the pack. While at the beginning, people were just uploading raw gameplay, voiceover soon followed. Rather than just show above average game footage, some people began talking over their videos to explain what they were doing and how they were achieving such great scores.
One thing that might help you guys out is not sprinting all the time. I think some people have a habit of sprinting too much, and especially when you're sniping, it's a lot easier. When I get a kill, I like to sprint away from it because when people see the red dot, they usually run towards it.
This is where Hutch shined. It was immediately recognizable that he wasn't the stereotypical 12-year-old gamer with Cheeto dust under his fingers. Hutch was incredibly well-spoken and able to articulate his thoughts, ideas, and reasons for doing things in-game fantastically, and in a very humble fashion, never thinking that he or what he was doing was a big deal. To him, he was just another guy on YouTube. What followed was a perfect storm of sorts, a likable, relatable guy like Hutch, producing content of which only a handful of other people were doing at the time, on a game that was exploding in popularity. When people would look to the internet for helpful tips or just any content generally relating to Call of Duty, there was a chance a Hutch video would pop up. After some time, Hutch had the most popular video game channel on YouTube. Tens of thousands of people subscribed to see his next video, which was unheard of at the time for a channel structured around gaming. So you have a successful YouTube channel that's growing rapidly and drawing new eyes every day. What do you do? Well, in Hutch's case, he pointed those eyes in the direction of other content creators he enjoyed and shared that spotlight.
So I'd like to take this opportunity now to showcase some other gameplay commentary guys on YouTube that I feel are doing a really good job. And today I'm going to post a video for you guys by a guy named CNanners. And today I want to give you guys some gameplay from my buddy John, otherwise known as S&D's. His YouTube is Sinwin, one of the funniest fucking guys you'll ever meet in your life, and he's really good with a sniper rifle, so hope you guys enjoy the video. Okay, so this is take two of the double commentary between Hutch and Only Use My Blade. You know what this reminds me of, Brian?
What?
Did you ever have an extremely awkward sexual experience where, like, it just didn't work out, and then, like, you take, like, a 10-minute break and try and come back to it?
Although plenty popular in their own right, and well-deserved, there's some chance your first time meeting CNanners, S&D's, a.k.a. Sinwin, or Only Use Me Blade, was through Hutch. The gaming scene on YouTube began growing larger and larger, and many people were watching, none of whom were more important than the folks over at Machinima. Machinima, a video entertainment company with content focused on gaming and its audience, had been on YouTube for a number of years, publishing in-house as well as viewer-submitted videos. These videos, however, were primarily focused on the art of Machinima that the company was named after. To give you the basic version, machinima is a combination of the words machine and cinema, and is the use of 3D engines, most of the time being video games, to create original shorts. As the popularity of videos simply featuring gameplay and voiceover, or gameplay commentary as most people refer to it as now, continued to grow, it began to leak onto the Machinima YouTube channel, and it was an immediate hit. What Machinima decided to do because of this would go on to change Hutch's life forever.
Typing, typing, typing. Oh, I didn't see you guys come in. I'm Mr. Sark. I'm at Machinima.com headquarters right now. Obviously, you can see by all the work I'm doing behind me. If you're watching this, then you have found your way to Machinima Respawn, which is our new YouTube channel that focuses on kick-ass gameplay submitted to us by you guys.
With Respawn, Machinima looked to build a commanding presence in the quickly growing gameplay space. And how would they achieve this? Well, simple. Gather the top gameplay content producers on YouTube and pay them to submit content for the channel. And by doing so, migrate their audiences over to Respawn.
Hey kids. So, I got an interesting email today from a little company called Machinima.com. And they actually offered me a partnership, or a sponsorship, I think is what they called it, to provide them with content, meaning the videos that I make.
One of the first to have this offer extended to them was Hutch. And boy, did people like Hutch. You see, not only did Respawn benefit from the influx of viewers brought on by the different content producers, the producers themselves benefited heavily as well. Respawn introduced fans of one YouTuber to another, and another, and another. Hutch would continue posting Call of Duty gameplay commentaries to Respawn and his channel, giving tips and helping new players, but how many tips can you really give? And how many times can you talk about the same game?
Gameplay commentaries used to be, at least for me, just talking about what was going on in the game, like, I'm playing on fucking bug, and I'm using the M40, and this gun's awesome, and you wanna watch down that sightline over there. But then it turned into, like, I mean, I don't know how many times you can talk about the map bug or an M40, but, like, you can't really talk about those things every video you make. And so I ended up just talking about what was up in my life.
This was nothing new to YouTube, as people had been recording daily activities from their lives from the beginning. This was very new to the little gaming corner of YouTube at the time. Content producers played games and talked about them. Viewers tuned in to hear these thoughts, learn some tips, and see some high scores. That's it. It's what separated a YouTube gamer from a YouTube video blogger. They both posted very different content for very different audiences. Hutch began to blur that line, however.
Video games is like the great unifying factor, right? And so if you break that barrier of, I don't know, familiarity right away, then people are more receptive to other things.
You know what, I'm not going to talk about the gameplay today. I've got special guest with me. Got the two-time national Call of Duty champion on the women's division of the Deserto Sports League, Debbie Hutchinson.
Hello.
Do you feel proud of all your accomplishments within the Call of Duty community?
Oh, absolutely.
Why don't you tell them who you really are?
I'm Shaun's, oops, Hutch's mom.
So this is launch week for this game, and I've been playing this game a lot. Has there ever been a time throughout the week where you've thought to yourself, fucking goddammit, can't he just put the control over here and spoon me? Can't he just wrap his incredibly masculine arms around me and make me feel like a woman?
Incredibly masculine.
Yes.
Yes. Indeed. No, I was agreeing.
Hutch introduced us to his family, his friends, and his then-girlfriend. Instead of talking tips over gameplay, the talking began to shift to whatever he had on his mind and whatever he was feeling at the time. Doing these things brought down the wall that YouTube inevitably creates. The content producer produces the content, and the viewer watches it. End interaction. But not here. There's a big difference between being spoken at and spoken to. It's the difference in simply showing up to be entertained and showing up because you feel a connection to what you're watching. If we're talking video games, it's the difference between, let's say, ironically, a Call of Duty where you pop the disc in, shoot people, and check out. in a game like BioShock that emotionally invests the player into the story. Feeling that connection, although some bad came with the good, the news Hutch would share with his viewers next would make them very, very happy.
Alright, so I guess this is my little update video. I've had some news that I wanted to share with you guys for quite a while now, but I haven't been able to talk about it until now. So not even 2 days after I'd come home from San Francisco, I got a phone call from Machinima offering to fly me down and talk to them in person. And then I get pulled into the office by two guys that have, two guys that are up there in the totem pole. And I sit down and they talk to me for about 5 minutes about how well my videos have been doing and how happy they were to have me on board. And at the end of that conversation, I was offered a job. To work for Machinima. Full-time job, salary, benefits, vacation, things like that.
Looking for a change of scenery, Hutch reached out to Machinima to see if they had a place for him. After a couple of test runs working on the Respawn show with host Mr. Sark, it was clear the chemistry was there and the audience loved the pair together. Soon after, Machinima brought Hutch in full-time as a producer and host for the Respawn channel.
I got you a little present! Go ahead, come on, open it! Open it! Oh, you can't because you're not here. I'll open it for you. It's a Hutch! It's a Hutch, we did it! Yes!
Now, a part of the Machinima team, it was an entirely different world for Hutch. From producing simple videos in the comfort of his own home, he was now in LA and working in a professional production. While many good times were ahead, there would be plenty of challenging moments as well.
There's been many situations working at Machinima where I was totally fucking terrified. Like, you go to E3 and you're supposed to interview some developer about a game that you don't know about and you have zero experience in interviewing or just, I don't know, like that sort of an exchange with no prior knowledge. But you just do it, you pretend like you know what you're doing, and then take notes afterwards, and then the next time it's easier.
Aside from appearing on camera practically every day to host Respawn, a challenge in itself at first, Hutch would also be providing Machinima with event coverage and interviews, all things he had no prior experience with. This presented opportunities for Hutch to speak with people like Josh Olin, the former Treyarch community manager, or Robert Bowling, the former creative strategist at Activision, and David Vonderhaar, the game design director at Treyarch. Although Hutch would interview others, some of his best came when speaking to representatives from the Call of Duty franchise because of his knowledge and passion for these games. Another challenge, this time tackled head-on by Hutch, was the thought of producing more mature, high-quality content. Wanting to learn more about production, Hutch dove right in and began working on new shows for Machinima. He created Engineering Win, a show that brought a team of solid, first-person shooter players together, along with Hutch, to break down and give tips on gameplay submitted by the audience.
I like the pre-nade off the start, because the last thing you want is a pro getting a sniper.
Lost the lead. Tied the leader. Lost the lead.
Quality Time with Hutch, featuring gameplay commentary by Hutch, sometimes accompanied by a guest. Quality Time saw a particularly interesting stretch called Roundtable, where Hutch would sit down with other Machinima employees to discuss current events in the gaming world.
The first thing that I want to talk about was EA's John Riccitiello, right?
Yep.
He's the president of EA?
CEO, I believe.
CEO of EA. And he basically made a statement saying that with Battlefield 3, they are gunning for Call of Duty.
Then there was arguably the most interesting and impressive series Hutch put together for Machinima, called Progression. Progression was a look at past Call of Duty games leading up to the release of the newest entry for the franchise.
Ah, Call of Duty 2. Where online multiplayer all began for us console folks. It was a simpler time then. One didn't have to worry about which perk to choose for the third slot, or which killstreak would work best on the map they were about to play. No, sir. Call of Duty 2 was straight gun versus gun, and skill versus skill.
These challenges were great for Hutch, as they showed him what he was capable of accomplishing when pushed. And as mentioned earlier, while there were challenges, there were plenty of great fun moments for Hutch at Machinima.
Gonna get into a car and not go somewhere.
I'm a little unmotivated today. You've never had a day where you just don't want to fucking go out and.
No, I have one of those days.
I don't
want to
drive
just,
anywhere.
No, man,
I don't want to fucking drive anywhere!
Yeah, let's stay. Let's just.
This fire is out of control. We're gonna burn this, burn it, I'll burn it.
Fuck you, Borough.
I just feel like this isn't concealed at all.
Well, quit fuddling around like a
God, how did you say that? Let him move on, man.
Unfortunately, all things come to an end, and Hutch's run on YouTube was no exception. After years of creating content and sharing his life with his viewers, Hutch, seemingly out of nowhere, decided it was best for him to leave Machinima, LA, and YouTube altogether. Without any explanation, Hutch was gone. No new video to watch the next day, nothing. Shocked and confused by this information, fans immediately began an outpouring of love for Hutch. The comment section of Hutch's last video filled up with heartfelt messages, and "Goodbye Hutch" began trending on Twitter as people used the hashtag in tweets, recollecting their favorite Hutch moments and what he meant to them. As long as the YouTube gaming scene is alive and growing, Hutch will be known as the godfather of the gameplay commentary. The first guy plucked from the crowd and hired by Machinima, and the guy who walked away from it all. But he'll be remembered for much, much more, for the impact, no matter how big or small, he had on the people who made sure never to miss a video. For being the guy you could relate to when you were both going through a tough time, maybe you had nowhere else to go, and just listening to someone else talk about their troubles made you feel better. For being the guy that inspired you to create your own YouTube channel, to try something different, to get out of your comfort zone. For being the guy you watch mess around with Sark, Nanners, and Hollywood on Respawn, it gave you a good laugh that time you really needed it. Over the course of a person's life, there are only a few people who will ever really leave a lasting impression. Wouldn't it be something if one of those people was a stranger you met on the internet? Yeah, wouldn't that be something?